Well, today, health experts and breast cancer advocates from all over California are going to be gathering at the state capitol. They'll be lighting the capitol pink tonight. That ought to be kind of cool. And they're going to try to close the gap in breast cancer awareness. So joining us today, Shelley Fultonasso is the director of public policy for the Susan G. Komen for the Cure group. And then Rebecca McClure Becknell is here. She is a breast cancer survivor. Thank you to both of you for coming in. Are you looking forward to tonight and the group of people you're going to have gathered?
Yeah, we're really excited about the rally. We're turning the Capitol pink because we think it's a really visible reminder of breast cancer awareness and really tying it to government and public policy, because we're here to talk about closing the gaps in access to care that cause low-income and poor women to die from breast cancer at higher rates than women with insurance.
Can anybody show up? I mean, there is always something going down at the Capitol. If you take a drive around it, there's always a group out there, you know, either protesting or trying to get support for something. But can anybody literally go
tonight?
Absolutely.
We would love for everybody to join us. It's at 5:30 at the Capitol, and then we're marching to the Crest Theater for a rally and concert with some celebrities. Edna Campbell will be joining us, and it's going to be a great evening. And we have dinner as well, so
and
anybody can
Renee
join
Seiler
us.
Renee Seiler is also going to be there. Right. She used to be on the CBS Early Show, and she recently dealt with another bout of breast cancer. I know it's been huge in her family.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Okay, well, Rebecca, tell us a little bit about your story. How long ago were you diagnosed?
Actually, it'll be 8 years this year. I was 27 when I was diagnosed.
Very young,
yeah, yeah. Life-shattering, but then also it was a blessing in disguise.
How so?
You know what? When I was diagnosed, you didn't hear a lot about young women and breast cancer. And so at that time, I felt like I was the only person out there, but really I wasn't. And two, it's given me a platform to be able to do things like this, to share my story, to share my experience, to show that with early detection, you can live a full and thriving life. So
what would you tell maybe some of the ladies who are watching now about what it's like to go to one of these events and to be around? Even maybe you have somebody in your family who's been diagnosed, or maybe you've been diagnosed yourself. What do you get out of going to these things?
It's just a great feeling to see so many people that come out and support, you know, a person that has been diagnosed with breast cancer. If you've ever been out to the walk and just to see that sea of pink shirts and then just all the people that are out there. So, like, tonight will be just another one of those great...
Yeah, there's a lot of energy at
yes,
these events.
Great
is
event.
Your health good now?
Yes.
Glad
very
to hear
well,
that.
Well.
The public is invited, of course, to come to the Close the Gap event tonight. At 5:30, they're going to turn the Capitol pink. I see how they do that. Then at 6:15, there will be a march, a rally, and a concert at Sacramento's Crest Theater. So it should be a great night. Thank you very much, both of you, for coming in, and good luck tonight.
Thank you.